same mass of copper is drawn into two wires of 1 mm thick and 3 mm thick. Two wires are connected in series and current is passed. Heat produced in the wires is in the ratio. Okay. So here, same mass of copper. So resistivity will be same, and also same mass they have said. So density will be same. So resistivity will be same, and volumes also will be same. The thickness of one wire is 1 millimeter and the thickness of another wire is 3 millimeter. Now, masses are same, M1 equal to M2. Say this is okay. So now M1 equal to M2, A1 into L1 into density, volume into density is mass, masses are equal, A2 L2 into density. Densities are same, but cross sectional areas and lengths will be different here. Now, so area of this one, so pi D1 square by 4 into L1 equal to pi D2 square by 4 into L2. This will be cancelled here, pi will be cancelled here. Diameter of the first wire is 1 millimeter. So let it be in millimeter. 1 square into L1 is equal to, this is 3 square into L2. So now from this you will get the relation between lengths. So L1 equal to 9 L2 or L1 by L2 equal to 9, the ratio of lengths. Now, resistance is given by rho L square by V0, where V0 is volume. So, rho and volume are same. So, resistance is proportional to L square. Now, R1 by R2 equal to L1 by L2 whole square. So, R1 by R2 is equal to 9 whole square, that equal to 81. Ratio of resistances will be 81:1. Now, when they are connected in series, current will be same. Now, the ratio of heats produced, H1 by H2 equal to, current will be same, I square R1, T will be same. So, I square R2 into T. So, T will be same, I will be same. So, ratio of heats produced will be in the ratio of resistances. What is the ratio of resistance? 81:1.